Welcome. Today, we are going to outline the teachings of Jesus and the role of the Holy Spirit. And then we look at the activities of the church, showing that the Holy Spirit is working among Christians. And lastly, we state ways in which the gifts of the Holy Spirit have been abused in the church today. Before we outline the teachings of Jesus on the role of the Holy Spirit, we are going to read John chapter 14 from verse 15 to 26 on teachings of Jesus on the role of the Holy Spirit, Revised Standard Version. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever. Even the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you desolate. I will come to you yet a little while, and the world will see me no more, but you will see me. Because I live, you will live also. In that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, he it is who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father. And I will love him, and I manifest myself to him. Judas, not Iscariot, said to him, Lord, how is it that you will manifest yourself to us, and not to the world? Jesus answered him, if a man loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. He who does not love me does not keep my words, and the word which you hear is not mine, but the Father's who sent me. These things I have spoken to you while I am still with you, but the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring your remembrance all that I have said to you. Teachings of Jesus on the role of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a counselor. Number two, he comforts Jesus' disciples when aggrieved. Teaches deeper truth concerning God to believers. He makes believers become children of God in baptism. The Holy Spirit guides Christians in all undertakings. Verse 6 reminds Christians of the deeper meaning of Jesus' words. Helps Christians to worship God in spirit and in truth. He continues Jesus' work of forgiving sins. He gives Christians strength and courage to witness for Christ. He exposes sins of the world and convicts the world for failure to believe in Jesus. He is a companion to every Christian. He encourages Christians to preach the gospel. He reveals the glory of Jesus. He convinces people to see their sin and seek righteousness through repentance. And lastly, he shows the right of Jesus to be the Son of God. Activities of the church showing that the Holy Spirit is working among Christians. So here, one is supposed to talk about the actions that show presence of the Holy Spirit in the church. So number one, in praying, in decision-making in the church, in faith, healing, in speaking in tongues is one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, in singing and dancing, in giving of alms and offertory, through courage displayed during condemning of evils in the society, in holding fellowship meetings, in preaching and teaching the gospel, in celebrating of the sacraments, in bringing new converts to church, in pastoral care and counseling, in helping the needy in the society, in ecumenical movement of churches in writing Christian literature, and lastly in confessing of sins. Ways in which the gifts of the Holy Spirit have been abused in church today. Number one, some Christians pretend that they have a certain gift, the Holy Spirit. Number two, some people ask for money before praying for or healing the sick. The gift of prophecy and wisdom have been abused, leading to misinterpretation of the Bible. And scriptures, Christians may impact demonic powers to innocent Christians. Some Christians who possess the gift of the Holy Spirit develop spiritual pride, wrong use of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Lastly, some use the gifts to bring division in the church. Kindly add more points in the comment section and let me know what you want I look at in tomorrow's video. Thanks a lot for subscribing and listening to me. God bless you.